Yes, this is exactly the answer. You must kiss me.
Excuse me?
You will enjoy.
Disney's much-anticipated new movie, The Princess and the Frog, is now playing in theaters, so should you see it, rent it, or skip it? Kevin Carr, movie critic from fatguysatthemovies.com, even though he's not fat, and I always tell him that, is joining us this morning.
Well, thank you. Thank you for... I'm trimmer.
How are you? Good to see you. My daughter loved this movie, The Princess and the Frog. She's seven. Her friends loved it, too. It's an interesting movie. Starts off like a typical fairy tale, but then there's a big twist. Tell me about it.
Well, it's a spin on the Frog Prince story, where instead of her just bringing a frog back to a prince, she becomes a frog herself. And it's this adventure. It's actually kind of a... It goes in some weird directions and some unique directions, which is really kind of cool, because it's not just a rehash of an old fairy tale. They put it in the Louisiana Bayou in New Orleans during the Depression, and it's actually the first time they've had an African-American lead character in a princess. Which
is, which is very significant, of course.
Absolutely, and it's also significant because it's a throwback to the 2D animation, the cel animation that Disney used to do, and it really has that feel of the stuff they did in like the late 80s, the 90s, with Little Mermaid and Beauty and the Beast. So it really hits those marks, and it has music by Randy Newman, and it's got some really good songs in it. My favorite is Keith David, who plays the evil voodoo doctor, who's, who's the bad guy, and he's fantastic.
Interesting you talk about the animation. Can you, I'm looking at it now. What is the difference between what they've been doing recently and the old style?
Well, what they did in the mid-2000s, they got rid of their 2D animation, which they actually hand-draw and they paint on cells and that sort of thing. And they all went to computer-generated stuff like Pixar movies.
Yeah.
Well, and John Lasseter, who's from Pixar, when he was put in charge of Disney Studios animation, he wanted to go back to hand-drawn stuff. And that's really where there's an art to this and there's a beauty. And I love the fact that this has come back and they brought it back.
All right. So as a parent, did you enjoy it too? Because, you know, with a Disney movie and we always take our kids. Usually I love them. Yeah. Did you like this yourself?
Oh, absolutely. It's something that kids can like and parents can like. And that's really been the charm of these feature film that Disney does. And this is classic Disney.
Princess and the Frog, Kevin, see it, rent it, or skip it.
I'm going to say see it.
See it. All right. Next up, Invictus, starring Morgan Freeman and Matt Damon. It's a little history lesson, really, in this movie, too, about Nelson Mandela.
Yeah, it's when Nelson Mandela first assumes office of the South African presidency, right at the end of apartheid, and it really does have a historical and cultural significance. And what he does is he rallies the country around the rugby team, so hoping they'll win the World Cup. It's a well-shot movie. It's a well-acted movie. Morgan Freeman and Matt Damon do very good jobs in it. It's just there's a little bit something missing there. It's not Clint Eastwood's best film.
Okay. Oh, directed by Clint Eastwood, too.
Yeah. He usually comes out with at least one or two movies every year at the Oscar season, so this is his shot. But it's... part of it is I'm just a big dumb American. I don't get rugby. So I was a little confused during the big climax.
It's becoming more and more popular here, too, but you know, it's so popular internationally.
Absolutely.
Morgan Freeman, I love. Matt Damon, I think, can be hit or miss, and I hear he has an accent.
Yeah.
How does he pull it off?
He does. The part of the problem is the South African accent it sounds odd.
It's like English, isn't it?
It's English, but it sounds like a bad English accent.
Okay.
And it's a true accent. And if you saw Blood Diamond a couple years ago with Leonardo DiCaprio, he did it, and he sounded kind of silly, but it's an accurate accent. I mean, Matt Damon does a good job. Morgan Freeman does a good job, and if you really love Clint Eastwood and these guys in the movie, you may want to check it out. But for me, I'm gonna have to say rent it.
Rent it.
Yeah.
Okay, so not see it, rent it. It's probably not worth your movie money first run. Kevin Carr from fatguysatthemovies.com. Great advice.
Thank you.
We'll see you again soon.
All right.
Happy holidays to you.